Hatfield Polytechnic, where this week topics of conversation or argument in the student common room have been dominated by financial concerns. For Liam Tegg, reading business studies, Steve Woollett, reading economics, and thousands of others in the southeast, there's been a summer without a job and without state benefit. Students themselves say they're in the red before lectures have even begun.
Just nearly everyone I know has got an overdraft, and the worrying thing is that if you're doing a 3 or 4 year degree, your overdraft just piles up each year. And especially with the present economic climate, there's no guarantee that you're going to be able to work that off at the end of your course.
For many students, I think an overdraft at the end of it, the first year of study, of several hundred pounds would not be atypical. Some are in debt to the extent of £1,000 or more. It depends very much on how they've actually got by in previous years.
Last year, 80 students at Hatfield alone applied for urgent assistance from a financial hardship fund. This academic year, and after only 3 days, there have already been 60 applications. Student welfare officers at London, Reading and Surrey have reported similar findings. Liam Tegg is just one student seeking financial counselling. This morning he made an appointment with a polytechnic welfare officer. Working part-time, studying the rest of the time, he still hasn't the money to pay for essentials.
No one really knows where their money's going to come from, how much grant they're going to get through and when it's going to come. So their bank balance is running down day by day.
The recession has hit the southeast, in particular with job losses, and they're coming back with nothing with which to pay new deposits, nothing with which to pay their summer retainers on their rent, no money saved, as it were, and just increasing debts.
Tutors say the hardship could result in students being forced to give up an outstanding opportunity because they can't afford it. Jonathan Ray for Thames News.